anything that's jumping out at you this year at InfoSec?
Well, look, I mean, there's always the stuff that stays the same, like everyone's trying to copy their messaging and blah, blah, blah. But that, I mean, the focus that we're asking, again, a lot of questions asked about human behavior.
Okay.
And how can we try and, you know, just understand the ebb and flow of people and,
yeah.
you know, try and spot the bad, but keep the good going, that
yeah.
sort of thing. What else are we seeing? We're seeing an awful, well, you know, I'm from a gaming background.
Yeah,
really.
I've heard.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm very curious. I want to know more about this.
Several people have asked me about this. So I used to be a Clash of Clans YouTuber.
So you're going to have to tell me what that is. I'm sorry.
It's an online game.
Okay.
So it's made by this company called Supercell.
Okay.
Supercell sold their company to a Chinese company called Tencent for $5
billion. Casual?
Casual. They got 150 people in their business. But one of the things that really can apply really well to our industry
yeah.
is the fact that they turn their whole model on the head. The,
okay, so tell me
more. Well, their CEO is called Ilkka Bananen.
Okay.
Yeah, I've got to practice that name.
I don't think I could repeat that.
Yeah, but he calls himself the least influential, least powerful CEO in the gaming industry.
Okay, and why is that?
Well, it's because what he does is, you know, normally you have a structure where the CEO's at the top, and the middle managers are in the middle, and the guys in the bottom.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
So they have to do what the guys at the top tell them, right? And
okay,
the guys
yeah.
in the middle very rarely actually want to tell the guy at the top that's a bad idea, because they want his
worry,
or her job.
Right?
Right, yeah, exactly, yeah. So what he's done is he said, look, all of the power goes to the actual people that do stuff.
Interesting.
What a great idea.
It is a great
yeah.
idea. I think more organizations
yeah.
should have.
So his job as the CEO is to fund it and to control governance and the,
okay.
and the managers of whom
so
they're...
he doesn't actually have much say in the direction
no,
of
not
strategy.
At all. Nothing at all. He's got as much value as the next employee.
I like it.
So the guys at the bottom who are writing the games could do... They could, like, spend $100 million if they all want to do it, right?
Okay.
On a marketing campaign or something.
Kind of like is that how they
so,
do it?
Yeah, so it's very democratic. You know, there's a lot of trust in amongst themselves. Now, this model is not going to work with things like armies, right? You know,
no,
you,
know not.
You shoot him. No, no, you shoot him.
Yeah.
Or maybe a bank. It's like,
yeah.
should we lend that person $100 million? Yeah, sure, no matter.
Yeah, it's not really,
yeah.
it's not a fit for every business,
sure.
for every industry, right?
Absolutely, but it's super awesome model to follow. Oh, excuse me, sorry. Where. Yeah, see, what we can do is we can use shadow IT to harvest digital transformation, harvest what the users are doing themselves,
yep.
and use that to better inform the decisions that an organization
amazing,
makes.
No?
How cool is that?
It's also logical.
Yeah,
it
makes sense. It's kind of almost crowdsourcing digital transformation.
Yeah.
That maps over really nicely to people like Brian Solis, who has created a digital transformation six-stage plan,
okay.
where stage two is pockets of experimentation.
Okay.
Stage three is where the experimentation starts to become mainstream. So you could harvest the digital transformation that people are doing
mm-hmm.
and do more of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do more.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
But yeah, so how about you? What are you seeing in today?
So a lot of the things that I've seen thus far
is
so we're seeing a lot of our clients and partners speaking about cloud and everyone transforming and going to the cloud and what does that mean, all of the challenges related to that.
And do you think the vendors are making it easy for people to understand how to solve some of these problems?
I think they're trying to.
Okay.
I'm not sure if they're actually getting there, but it's definitely an evolution, right? These things take time.
Sure.
And the security related to that, right?
Yeah.
Because as things evolve, we're used to such smaller environments, right? And
yeah.
where you can have more control. Where
yeah.
now that everything is on the cloud, people are getting scared. What about all of these IoT devices and
yeah.
how it's what takes one
yeah,
device,
yeah, yeah.
right?
Yeah, yeah.
Is there anything that you are looking forward to specifically for the rest of the event? Is there any specific keynotes or are there any booths that you're looking forward to?
Oh my god,
seeing?
Well, I've seen the best ones. Did you see Kate Ades this morning?
I haven't.
Oh, that was fantastic. You know, sometimes people from outside of the IT industry have the best perspectives
yeah.
on the industry. In actual fact, I think there was some really good questions in the Bright Talk earlier about skills and resources.
Yeah.
I think there's a lot to be said about not hiring IT people into the IT organization because you need different perspectives.
Yeah, no, for sure. I actually was on a panel recently and it was women in tech. And it was interesting because we had people from all different landscapes and backgrounds and it was someone even say a marketer in tech, right? So you have these different perspectives and you have people from different industries and backgrounds and it gives a much broader and full picture view of
yeah.
IT security, right?
Oh, you know what? The diversity is what what makes us wonderful. And living in London, I mean, I live in, near the Shard, and it's one of the most diverse parts of London. People often say, you know, that the political thing that's going on right now, where, you know, it's either you're in this camp or you're that camp. Yeah. That's totally wrong. You know, what really matters is how different we can be.
Yeah, and be together, right?
Well, when we're different, we're, you know, we have different ideas and we learn together.
Yeah, definitely.
It's awesome.
Well, thanks for being with us today, and I look forward to seeing you throughout the event.
Can't wait, yeah. Brilliant. Cheers. Take care. Bye.